Are you developing MLCC and seek for high density, high efficiency solution in a compact case size? I'm Alexandra Ans, application engineer at Samsung Electromechanics, and in this tech snack, you will learn why it's so important to consider both the TCC and DC-bias when selecting an MLCC. Hello everyone! In today's tech snack, we will discuss the importance of deep diving into MLCC specification. In this case, Class 2 MLCC X7R versus X7S. Stay tuned to find out how to select the best alternative for your electronic application. The most common MLCC multi-layer ceramic capacitors in the industrial and automotive markets come with a TCC, temperature coefficient of capacitance, known widely as X7R, when the X stands for minus 55 degrees Celsius, the 7 for plus 125 degrees Celsius, and the R for plus minus 50% tolerance over this temperature range. With its narrow capacitance change tolerance band of plus minus 50%, many design engineers will simply select the X7R product over X7S. However, when choosing an MLCC, it is important to consider not only the TCC, but also DC bias, namely the capacitance change at the applied DC voltage. Samsung Electromechanics, also called SEMCO, focuses on MLCC solution that provides strong performance in both TCC and DC bias parameters. And while some X7R products offer better DC bias than X7S, the opposite is also true, with certain X7S MLCC providing a distinct advantage. So how come not so many companies are specifying X7S MLCC? The answer, it appears, is nothing more than a lack of awareness. In modern automotive and industrial electronics, higher integration and increasing functionality are common trends, both of which tend to demand more and more capacitance. Here, an MLCC offering a TCC with X7S characteristics possibly provides higher effective capacitance than an MLCC that has a TCC with X7R attributes at the same nominal capacitance rating. Because TCC is just one factor that affects capacitance, another major influencer is DC bias. DC bias is the change in capacitance when a DC voltage is applied across the terminals. The capacitance value will drop as DC voltage rises, which can negatively affect many types of circuit. Then what are the design challenges? There are a number of ways that OEMs can develop MLCC with higher capacitance value, most of which typically involve improvement in ceramic materials. For example, a smaller grain size allows thinner layers, while additional grain treatment can improve homogeneity and reliability. In addition, improved material doping can increase the relative dielectric constants. All of these factors can lead to higher capacitance values. Any design engineer seeking a high-density, high-efficiency solution in a compact case size can benefit from this MLCC. Application that demand high electrical precision stability and reliability will see gains, including power supply bypass circuits, consumer electronics, and telecommunication equipment. Delivering capacitance stability depends on achieving a good balance on MLCC properties that can derive the best performance from these usage conditions. In the following graph, we can observe the class 2 behaviors for MLCC, especially for the X7 family, X7R, X7S, and X7T. In the X-axis, we can visualize the temperature in degrees Celsius and in the y-axis, the capacitance percentage. If we can increase the temperature, we can observe how the percentage of the capacitance is decreasing. How we behave TCC codes and range table depends on the temperature characteristic for each code. How about the capacitance loss on class 2 MLCC? All class 2 MLCC formulation, including X7R and X7S, vary in capacitance value according to applied DC voltage, TCC, and time. The latter, for instance, occurs as ceramic grains lose the ability to reorientate over time, largely to the need of domains to find energetically more stable states. This domain stabilization leads to a decrease in relative permittivity, which translates directly into a loss of capacitance. Of course, most design engineers already know that DC bias significantly decreases the effective capacitance of class 2 MLCC. Just to clarify, both X7S and X7R formulation are temperature stable ceramics that fall into EIA class 2 materials. Along with TCC and aging, these three factors depend on each other, whereby improving one will have an impact on one or both other factors. The broad consensus is that enhancing both TCC and DC bias simultaneously will only result when there is a future improvement in the overall ceramic powder system. Then, does X7S offer better DC bias? In SEMCO, our X7S MLCC lineup can possibly offer better DC bias than X7R counterparts. To demonstrate this, we run a series of measurements setting out the DC bias performance characteristic of a SEMCO X7S MLCC and an X7R device from another manufacturer. In terms of a specification, both were 1 microfarad, 10% tolerance, 6.3 volts MLCC in 0402 package case size. The measurements revealed that the SEMCO X7S MLCC showed a capacitance change rate of approximately -30.7% at 4 volts. In comparison, the other supplier's X7R MLCC demonstrated a notably more sizable capacitance change rate of around -50.6% at 4 volts. As already stated, there is some impact on TCC due to the improvement on DC bias. At 4 volts and 85 degrees Celsius, the SEMCO X7S MLCC saw a -6% capacitance change rate compared with +6% at 4 volts 85 degrees Celsius for the MLCC from the other manufacturer. As the graph shows, the SEMCO X7S 1 microfarad MLCC remains the better overall performer, still delivering capacitance of 0.59 microfarad at 4 volt, 85 degrees Celsius, compared with just 0.52 microfarad for the X7R. Any electronic or electronic component engineers involved in the automotive, industrial, or other markets will gain rewards from taking a closer look at X7S for their high capacitance MLCC requirements. The results set out by SEMCO demonstrate that X7S MLCC can sometimes offer a notably better DC bias than like-for-like X7R counterparts. Even when taking TCC into consideration, X7S MLCC often show themselves as the best overall performers. There are many ongoing developments in MLCC design as suppliers look to meet the increasingly high demands of engineers in the modern electronics industry. Research into new materials in the effects of parameters such as TCC and DC bias mean that correct MLCC selection hinges very much on the specific application. X7R and X7S MLCC can provide the optimal solution depending on the project's objectives. For designers wishing to avoid handing the advantage to competitors, the overriding message is to not simply continue with historical MLCC choices for new projects, but to consider all options. The gains available might provide a rewarding surprise. I hope you enjoyed this tech snack. You can discover our latest X7S portfolio in automotive and industrial grade on aero.com and Samsung website.